don't know if this is working.
Now there's pressure. I did good last time. I better be funny again. All right. I don't really have jokes this time. I have stories. Anyone want to hear a good story? Yeah. Someone wanted to hear a good story. They're like, yeah, I haven't heard a story in years. All right. Well, so good news. Just found out I beat testicular cancer. Okay. Yeah. Testicular cancer free. To be fair, I never had it in the first place. But I thought I did. I really thought I did. My balls were hurting for like a really long time. It was serious. I didn't know why. Trying to be all nonchalant with my friends. Like, hey, man, don't you hate when your balls hurt every day for 3 months straight? Trying to see if they can relate to that. They're like, no, dude, that shouldn't be a thing. So I'm getting worried. And I think I have cancer, mostly because WebMD told me I did. I feel like now, looking back at it, WebMD is not a reliable source. I could have typed in, I have the sniffles, and they were like, you have Ebola. All right. So, but I'm really concerned. And, you know, I don't go to the doctor for, like, ear infections, sore throats. But these were my boys, you know what I'm saying? These, I couldn't leave them hanging, you know what I mean? I mean, I'd leave them hanging. That's how it works. But no, I couldn't leave them hanging in this situation. So I call the doctor first, actually. I call him. Because, you know, it's just going to be free. She gave me some advice over the phone. Of course, I'll call him. So I tell her what's wrong. I tell the doctor what's wrong, how I'm feeling. She goes, okay, well, you're going to need to come in, take a urine sample. You might have an STD. And I was like, whoa, hold up. Sorry, I can't have an STD. I haven't had sex in a really long time. She's like, okay, that's understandable. It's just that we need a process of elimination when you find out if you do or do not have an STD. And I was like, listen, okay, I never had to convince anyone more that I haven't had sex in a long time. I'd be like, that's the only situation where you need to convince somebody you haven't had sex. I was like, I got a calendar right here. 6 months ago is when I last had sex. I wrote it down. And yes, I do have a calendar. I use it to write down friends' birthdays and the last time I had sex. And it's pretty empty right now because I don't have a lot of sex and I don't have a lot of friends. So, you know, she didn't believe me, though. She thought I was going around fucking everybody, giving everybody STDs, people giving me STDs. She thought I was fucking part of an orgy group or something. So I go in twice. First time was to do a urine sample. You know, I did it because, you know, I want to make sure I don't have an STD. Also, so I can prove that bitch wrong, okay? So do the urine sample, go back, find out the results. I'm a little nervous. She calls me in. I said, okay, good news, you don't have an STD. All right, let me say that again clearly for the ladies out there. My penis. Doctor approved, okay? No STDs. I got a piece of paper somewhere that says it. Probably pull it out next time. It's right there. But no, the story's not over, you guys, because they're still hurting down there, you know? The plot thickens, right? It's okay, it's not STDs, what the hell is it? Still be a chance it's cancer. So she goes, okay, last thing we could try, we're going to do an ultrasound. And I was like, oh shit, am I pregnant? No. Guys can do ultrasounds down there and see what's going on. I was like, okay, cool. So, you know, she sets me up with an appointment. I'm laying down. Nurse comes in and rubs jelly on my balls. Guys, it's not as sexy as it sounds, okay? So I don't recommend you doing it. Fucking put yourself in the dick. Just, I'm going to get an ultrasound. This sounds amazing. So she's rubbing it. She's rubbing her little... She's scanning my balls. She looks like a cashier at a grocery clerk looking for the barcode on some Kiwis. Okay, so she's down there doing her thing, and the whole time I just wanted to be like, is it a boy or a girl? Long story short, it wasn't a boy, it wasn't a girl, it wasn't even cancer. It was just swollen vein in my balls. It was a very personal story. I feel like you guys know a lot about me now. This next story, I'll try not to have it so personal. So I got a blowjob on the free air, right? And I know what you're thinking, like, well, everybody gets blowjobs. Harry Potter gets blowjobs on the freeway, I bet. This was different, okay? She was driving. That deserves a motherfucking round of applause. Come on, guys. She was driving and giving me a blowjob. She was crazy. I won't tell you how I did it. A magician doesn't reveal his secrets. But it was dangerous as fuck, so we almost crashed. We almost crashed, so we had to stop real quick. But I was saying that how awesome would it be if we didn't have a collision? The guy gets out, hey, what the hell are you doing? And I'm like, she was sucking my dick while she was driving. He's like, even a police officer, he'd be like, I saw you guys swerve. You guys been drinking? No, officer, she was sucking my dick while she was driving. Go ahead, you guys are good. All right, guys, you guys have been great. Thank you. Love you guys.